It's a lot of work to write a piece of music. Every one of those notes Sean had to put down on a piece of paper. Thank you, Sean. I really appreciate it. And that just about concludes our participation in today's event. We are going to finish with the Pakistan National Anthem.
Right. capital of Saskatchewan? The animal which is the symbol of Canada is? What is the polar bear capital of the world? The only remaining walled city in Canada is? The answer was Quebec City. The answer was not located, which is 5,959 meters high.
Thank you for taking the time to come and celebrate the 150th birthday of our beautiful country. Thank you, Your Honor, Your Worship, and to the Parliament. Thank you so much. And thank you to all the volunteers who have put months and months in formulating this program. Have a right of applause for them. I'd like to thank the town of Ajax and their Impact Ajax funding program on which the foundation of this program was laid. Town of Ajax helps the people who are doing diversity and inclusion, and they're always helped for that. Big round of applause for Town of Ajax. Things are changing over the past few years, we have noticed that. Appears that things are going back. The hate is coming in, and probably because of some patronage from the most strongest person in the world, maybe the people who are under the surface, they are coming up. But we have to fight it back. Hate progresses and establishes two things. One is fear, and second is isolation. So if you want to fight hate, come out of isolation. We cannot sit back and say that the hate will go away. No, we have to come out and fight and fight and fight. And it's very easy to do. Very, very easy to do. Go and volunteer. Meet with other people. Meet with the organization where other people from other community are working. Volunteer with Cancer Society, United Way, Salvation Army. Whatever, food banks, food kitchens, there's so many places to go and work. And let us try to make Canada the same country as before, that when a young man comes to here for 2 days, he falls in love with this country. Thank you so much. We have got the mayor of Ajax over here. I'd like him to please come and say a few words.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here. It was mentioned in my friend's speech, Impact Ajax. And Impact Ajax is one of a number of programs that the town sponsors to help groups in our community promote the basic ideals and fundamental values of our community. And this community is a very diverse community. And inclusiveness and diversity and sense of community is what we stand for. And events such as this that recognize our diversity, recognize the richness of our culture in this community and in this country, is something that we're very pleased to support and something that we're proud goes on in our community on a regular basis. And this event tonight, recognizing the 150th anniversary of our country and all the values of freedom and diversity and inclusiveness that it stands for, I think it's just such a wonderful tribute to your organization and to our entire community. So thank you very, very much. I would like to present the certificate to the Friends of Meet Canada PAC Canadian Society of Durham for the Music and History of Canada celebration tonight. And I want to thank you very, very much.
I also have had a pledge to give to the Town of Ajax, and it's my pleasure to give it to the Mayor. In appreciation of Town of Ajax for patronizing engagement and inclusiveness, Friends of Canada, Pakistani Society, Canadian Society of Durham. There's a piece of scarf which is from Pakistan. It is made in the southernmost part of Pakistan. All the work is done by hand. It's a block printing. And this is a symbol of love and peace. It is given to a person you want to honor. So on behalf of Pakistan Canadian Society, I'd like you to.
Your Honor, and it's good to have DRPS Charles right behind you. Feel very safe. It is not only Canada's 150th birthday, but it's also the 150th birthday of the province of Ontario. And I have a presentation I would like to make it today to this youngster right here. Both youngsters. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going to read the information, but it's what it is about this evening and the tremendous job that they have accomplished. It's for the Friends Indeed Canada Pakistani and Canadian Society of Durham. And I am presenting this one. I have two to present because we have one member who just got out of the hospital late yesterday. This is from myself. It is signed. The legislature, the group, with the gold seal of the province of Ontario, we never forget. And the second one is for a dear friend of ours and a minister in our provincial government, and that is MPP Tracy McCharles. And again, it is the Pakistani Canadian Society for Friends Indeed Canada. And I like what the message is. Very, very positive. I know your associations will take care to show it well. And I have this. I was hoping the less I speak, the greater the opportunity that we have to listen to the young lady on the aisle seat in the center aisle, Your Honor. It's always a pleasure to have you, and a very special evening, and we thank you very much.
All of the organizers, because I know how hard it is to plan such an event, and without volunteers in our community, you know, nights like this wouldn't be possible. So I too am looking forward to seeing the rest of the entertainment and hearing from our dignitaries that are with us tonight. So thank you very much.
Mesdames et Messieurs, please join me in welcoming the Honorable Elizabeth Dalzell, Lieutenant Governor of Ontario. What a delight it is to be here. Thank you for the invitation to join you for this concert and celebration of Canadian music in all its history and diversity. And I must say, there was a moment when the jazz was playing that you had to keep me in my seat. I'm sure it affected many of you in that way. And what better place to do so than here in Ajax? This is a community that prides itself on the commitment to diversity and inclusion, and I think in many ways it's the model for many Ontario communities. And Friends Indeed Canada, by committing to engage with all of its residents, no matter their background or beliefs, is leading by example. It seems only yesterday that we were beginning a year-long reflection on Canada's 150 years of Confederation, and it's been such a momentous year. It has motivated us to look back at our history, to remind ourselves of the progress we've made, mindful, of course, that Indigenous people have stewarded these lands for millennia before we even became Canada. But we've also had a wonderful opportunity to look forward. And I think we've asked some very important questions. How can we make the most of the great potential that we have? How can we be even better? How can we overcome the challenges that we still face? What will the Canada of 2167 look like? And will we have to wait that long before we are a fully inclusive and accepting society? Well, from what I've seen and heard, I'm one of those who's very optimistic. As your Lieutenant Governor, I've had the good fortune of being able to travel across this province and to speak with Ontarians north, south, east, and west from all walks of life. And many have told me stories that emphasize that we are stronger when we build bridges between cultures and communities. Many have spoken, as your chair just did, of Ontario as a place that not only welcomes immigrants, but one whose supportive environment has allowed them to flourish and thrive against what may seem insurmountable odds. Just in recent years, Canada has opened its doors to refugees from Syria, and the response from many Canadians has been overwhelmingly positive. But we know that the transition to really belonging and becoming a Canadian citizen takes time and considerable support. The stories show how, when we treat people fairly, we empower them to succeed in life. And surely this is something we should all strive for. And we can also see our imperfections and mistakes when we look back on this country's history with the clear eyes that maturity can bring. The path to respectful reconciliation with Indigenous peoples has been clearly mapped, but we know it will be a long and challenging journey. Yet I believe that we share a common goal. We want communities that are just and sustainable. We want a better life for our children. We want dignified work, quality education and health care. We want communities that are safe spaces in which to live. And we want to live together in peace and harmony, accepting our neighbors, protecting the vulnerable, and treating everyone with respect. We want to have the opportunity to participate fully in decision-making that charts our collective future. Communities that have these qualities at their core are resilient and can evolve, able to withstand the shocks of inevitable change. In our fast-paced world of blinding technological change, we're all connected in ways that were inconceivable a few decades ago. Not everybody's comfortable with embracing this change, and we must resist the increasingly common urge to isolate ourselves. It's all too easy, for instance, to retreat into the echo chamber of social media, where we only hear from a limited set of voices. It's essential that we reach out to other people, as Friends Indeed and organizations like it have done so often with your fundraising and support of important community groups. By looking outward and building bridges, we enrich ourselves and our communities. You know, there was a great Canadian thinker by the name of Marshall McLuhan who wrote about Canadians back in 1957. And he said this: "Our generous devotion to the values and interests of other cultures is our best assurance of a rich supply of nourishment which will foster what's ever good and sound in our own national life." Well, since McLuhan wrote those words, our country has become so much more diverse. And although we have embraced the promise of multiculturalism, prejudice and racism still exist here. When there's an epidemic of Islamophobia in Ontario, as one survey found last year, when the mayor of Brampton feels the need to speak out against hateful speech at a school meeting about prayer, as she did in March, when an imam in Mississauga receives a death threat, as Ibrahim Hindi did in April, when women in hijabs cannot go to the supermarket without facing racial abuse. This is shameful. This is a prejudice that may be driven by fear of something that's different or unknown. It may be a response to economic inequality or simply a reaction to hateful rhetoric. That is not the vision that's acceptable to most Canadians. We aspire to have a country that works for all of us and of which all can be proud. I think a first step on the journey of reconciliation and the defeat of intolerance, prejudice, and hate is to listen to each other's stories. Because when we do, reaching across the boundaries of culture and geography, we begin to develop an empathy that's the foundation on which inclusive societies rest. I've come to call myself Ontario's storyteller-in-chief, unofficially. I appointed myself. I do so because I have the privilege of having conversations with so many people. And I hear the stories of ordinary people living extraordinary lives. So this year rather, as one of our Canada 150 projects, we published a book of 150 stories written by Ontarians. And I'd like to share just one of them with you. They're all very short. This is written by Ramindirak Maharaj, and he writes, "It's unlikely that there's a single verifiable point when a place to which you have moved irrevocably becomes home. Perhaps it's never a dramatic moment of decision, but something more subtle, the quiet drip of familiarity that nudges your glance ever forward. A few years ago, I returned from a visit to another, older home. And as I wove my way around the other travelers at Union Station and boarded the GO train to Ajax, I began to imagine the scene that would soon flash by. As the train approached Rouge Hill, I found myself looking forward to the view of the lake and the pathways and the scrubby bush on one side and on the other the 401 with its maze of interlocking exits. For the first time that I could recall, I was not thinking of the place I had left behind, but of the place to which I was headed, Ajax. Gatherings such as this one encourage us to share our stories. We are in Ajax, assembled in a building that was built to celebrate one religion, but that welcomes those of other faiths. Tonight, many of us here are Pakistani-Canadian, and I'm an immigrant from Ireland. And together, we listened to a wonderful music performance that was planned for all of us. Music really crosses cultural boundaries and knits communities together. And I can hardly think of a way to celebrate the richness that is Canada than by using the power of art to unite us this evening. My gratitude goes to Mr. Reyes and Friends Indeed Canada for organizing tonight's event, and for all that all of you can do by encouraging everyone to look outward in the pursuit of a better and more inclusive Canada. My thanks go to so many of you in the audience here tonight because your spirit of openness, of curiosity, and of caring should give us all hope. I wish you a wonderful evening and a wonderful rest of Canada 150. Thank you.
And how am I celebrating Canada's 150 years? I'm not sure what to do. 2001.
Oh, goodness, I feel old.
I'm currently a student in our college at the social service worker program. But probably the thing I like about Canada is definitely the diversity. Where I come from, we're very monocultural, Ukrainian, so we're very, like, one race, pretty much. So, I don't think the different diversity of different countries is just scattered in one place. I'm celebrating just by going out with my family, just checking, enjoying the day together.
I'm
Yeah.
The fiddle is the